Let us take the fourth question. I'll mark this. Let's read what is given here. A thin cylindrical shell is 1 meter in diameter and 2.5 meter length, is subjected to uniform fluid pressure of 5 Newton per mm square, full stop. Find circumferential strain, longitudinal strain, volumetric strain and change in volume if thickness of the shell is 20 mm, full stop. Take capital E is equal to 200 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square and mu as 0.25. So this is the question which we have in front of us. Whatever is given in this question, we will write this in data. Here it is given that we have a thin cylindrical shell. So I'll draw the diagram. Having internal fluid at pressure. So here we have thin cylindrical shell is 1 meter in diameter. Small d is equal to 1 meter, 1000 mm. Next, 2.5 meter length. So the length of the cylinder is given. Is subjected to uniform fluid pressure, small p, 5 Newton per mm square. Find circumferential strain, the first question. Circumferential strain is also called as hoop strain. Next, longitudinal strain. Then, volumetric strain. And at last, change in volume. If thickness of shell is 20 mm, small t is given, the thickness of this shell. And then capital E and mu value, they are given in this question. So now, whatever is there in the form of data, let us try to get the solution for this problem. I'll say that in the solution part, first I will write down, since hoop stress is given by sigma suffix h is equal to pd upon 2t, therefore sigma suffix h is equal to internal pressure is given as 5 Newton per mm square, the internal diameter is 1000 mm, thickness is 20, so from this I will be getting hoop stress value as 1250 Newton per mm square. Because whenever they tell you to calculate hoop strain or longitudinal strain, first get the value of hoop stress and longitudinal stress. After this, I'll say that also longitudinal stress is given by PD upon 4T, or in other words, longitudinal stress can directly be taken as half of hoop stress. So therefore, longitudinal stress will be equal to, I can say that P is 5 and diameter was 1000, 4 into 20. So this value comes out to be 625 Newton per mm. So here I have hoop stress and longitudinal stress. So I can go for the calculation of hoop strain first. Since hoop strain is given by sigma suffix h, hoop strain I will denote it by E suffix h is equal to hoop stress upon Young's modulus minus mu into longitudinal stress upon Young's modulus. So therefore, hoop strain will be equal to 1 upon E. E is given as 200 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square. Hoop stress 1250 minus mu is 0.25. Longitudinal stress is 625. So if I calculate the value here, I will be getting hoop strain as the answer which I have calculated. It is 5.47 into 10 raised to minus 4. And since it is strain, it won't have a unit. First answer, Second is longitudinal strain. So longitudinal strain is given by therefore E suffix L is equal to 1 upon Young's modulus is 200 into 10 raised to 3. Longitudinal stress, it was 625 minus mu is 0.25 into hoop stress 1250. So from this I will be getting longitudinal strain as 1.56 into 10 raised to minus 4. That is my second answer. Next, after getting longitudinal strain, the question is volumetric strain. So I'll say that since volumetric strain is given by the formula of volumetric strain, it is equal to longitudinal strain plus twice into hoop strain. Therefore, longitudinal strain, I have an answer number 2, that is 1.56 into 10 raised to minus 4 plus 2 into hoop strain from answer 1, 5.47 into 10 raised to minus 4. Therefore, volumetric strain comes out to be 1.25 into 10 raised to minus 3. That is my third answer. And the last question which they are asking is to calculate change in volume. So once I have volumetric strain, I can say that also volumetric strain is equal to change in volume upon original volume. And that original volume, we can get it as the original volume would be V is equal to pi by 4 D square into L. Here D is 1000, L is 2.5 into 10 raised to 3 mm. So here I can write this as, therefore, change in volume will be equal to volumetric strain into volume, which is equal to 1.25 into 10 raised to minus 3. Volume is pi by 4 into diameter is given as 1000. Length is 2.5 into 10 raised to 3. So it is pi by 4 d square into L. So from this, the change in volume which I get, the answer comes out to be 2.45 into 10 raised to 6 mm cube. My fourth answer. So if we look into this question, they were telling us to calculate hoop strain. The answer is 5.47 10 raised to minus 4. Second question was longitudinal strain, and the answer is 1.56 10 raised to minus 4. Next, volumetric strain. The answer is 1.25 10 raised to minus 3. At last, change in volume, and that is 2.45 10 raised to 6 mm cube. With this, we have solved all the questions which they have given. And here, the problem number 4 gets completed.